What's going on, my PT peeps, my Walking Dead family, and my fighters? I'm One Eye Rye, also known as PT, and I'm back to talk about The Walking Dead. And how is Alpha and Lydia just walking among the walkers in Season 10, Episode 2, the opening minutes? Spoiler warning, obviously, for The Walking Dead Season 10, Fear the Walking Dead, and The Walking Dead Show, comics, all that stuff. Spoiler warning for The Walking Dead universe. But I'm asking how. I think we know the answer, but as always, we're here to discuss it, so let me know your thoughts, post your comments below. And first, guys, if you can, it's very important for us to hit that goal of 100,000 subscribers. And if you love The Walking Dead, hit that subscribe button so you don't miss out on our daily content. Well, the opening minutes of Season 10, Episode 2 start with a lady randomly crashing into the wall. I don't know how, why, when, but airbag deployed, face on the horn, drawing walkers towards her. She's like, oh, I'm bleeding. But for some reason, her door can't open on the driver's side, so she has to go through the passenger side and directly into the walkers. And this is the opening minutes of Season 10, Episode 2. And it's a backstory episode of Lydia, Alpha, and Beta, and it's 7 years ago from where we currently are on The Walking Dead. But again, the lady's like, oh, I can't get out this door, I can't get out this door. And instead of going through the back driver's side door, she goes through the passenger side door directly into the walkers. And if you look closely, you see walkers, 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 and Lydia and Alpha. And they're just walking amongst the walkers. They're in between them, right? And we do see blood, or what I think is blood, on Alpha and Lydia. And so I guess they're using the walker guts trick with the blood. But is it enough? Does it make sense? The lady crawls, well, tries to crawl underneath her minivan, and she gets bit in the leg. The lady flips over and she's, you know, taken apart by these walkers. But again, Alpha and Lydia are just walking between the walkers. You see Lydia's earmuffs. Would they really cancel out the noise? Probably not, but I guess they're supposed to. The lady gets bit in the leg, like I said. She's getting devoured by walkers. It's pretty gory. It's pretty great. I think they rip her nose apart. It's pretty crazy to watch. It's a great part of the episode. But you see the headphones, or the earmuffs, and are they really canceling any sound? Not really. A walker comes and bumps into Lydia, knocking the headphones off. She hears the walkers munching. She screams. The walkers turn their attention to them. And then it's all about Lydia and Alpha trying to get away. But you also see Alpha like acting like a walker. So are you really pantomiming a walker? And they're going, oh, she's a walker. She's one of us. Don't worry, guys. Don't get her. She's one of us. But since Lydia screams, all the walkers come towards Alpha and Lydia. And then Alpha and Lydia try to get away. And it's an Alpha, Beta, Lydia backstory whisper episode. And I'm excited for the episode. I'm not hating on it. This is just the opening minutes of it. But overall, you can see the blood on them. But it's really not that much. And I know it's just a story and it's fiction. And I'm not hating on it by any means. And it's more of a discussion and a debate. Do you buy into the fact the walker guts trick would work? I mean, we have to, right? It's part of the story. I mean, they don't even call them zombies. They call them walkers because a zombie doesn't exist. And I think it has to do with the comic, and you couldn't call them zombies in the comic because of the comic code or something. So they came up with the walker idea. But you can see Lydia and Alpha clearly have the walker blood. I'm guessing walker blood on them, but it's really not that much. Previously on other episodes and even the other series, Fear the Walking Dead, they are covered in the walker blood and guts. And just because Lydia screamed, the walker's like, oh, they're people now. But they still have the walker blood and guts on them. So is it a plot hole? Is it a mistake? Again, I'm looking past it. I'm just discussing it here. And I'm not nitpicking or putting it down by any means. I'm discussing it with a fun video, like always. So I think that it's a little too much. I can understand why they're doing it, but Lydia and Alpha are basically immune to the walkers here. They get away, of course, and of course Alpha and Beta are going to be the idea that they can control walkers. And I like the idea of using walkers and weaponizing walkers. And if you know my book series, Fight for Us, you know why that's important to me. And I just think at the end of the day, they're going to say and do whatever they can to build the fact that Alpha and Beta can control walkers. And they're using walkers to their advantage, and that's their biggest threat to our survivors. Alpha and Beta meeting should be pretty cool. I hope it is in Season 10, Episode 2. I haven't seen it yet, but like I said before, they used this trick before. But look how much they are covered. Look how much walker guts and blood is on them. Glenn's trying to act like a walker, and still the walker tried to get him. They use the meat ponchos right here, and I can understand the idea. Smell would definitely be masked with walker guts, but it would make you sick, right? It would definitely be like, ugh, this is gross. I like the idea of blending with walkers. It just seems a little too much at times, and the consistency, is it there or not? And I mean, in Fear the Walking Dead, Nick was covered. Look how much he is covered in walker blood and guts and whatever that's on him, right? They are covered. So that's what you would have to look like, I would assume, right? Even Luciana and the other people, they have it all over their face and body. And yes, I know it's a show, but I'm invested in the show, the series, the universe of this, and I just want it to be consistent and make sense. But at the end of the day, it's a fictional show, and I thought I'd bring it up to you. And it's definitely a theme in the Walking Dead universe. Nick did it, Rick did it, Glenn, so many people. Michonne had the walker blood and guts on them, some by accident, some by design. And it is a good idea in theory, but just sometimes it's a little too much. And it might sound better on paper than an actual film and television. But right here, Michonne is just walking with walkers, right? And she was blending in with the other walkers. I mean, she still smells like a person and a human being. She's just blending in with the walkers because she has two of them chained up. I can see why her pets didn't want to bite her or scratch her, because they can't. And I am glad that they did this with Father Gabriel and Negan, and we finally got someone sick with this. But I only think they got sick because of the radioactive material and waste on the walkers. And only Father Gabriel gets sick, not Negan. And if you put walker blood and guts on your body, on your face, you're breathing it in, it's in your sinuses, you would definitely get sick. And being a medical professional, I guess I see it a different way, but I am glad that somebody got sick. I kind of don't like that Father Gabriel got sick, but the show is the show, and I like what they do, and they have differences for characters, and it's pretty cool. But the other thing that I'm going to see probably in season 10, episode 2, is Alpha taking off her mask, right? So we're supposed to believe that Alpha looks like a walker, acts like a walker, and they don't get her. Okay, I'm down for that. But if you take off your walker skin mask and you just have your face, why wouldn't the walkers attack her? I mean, we're supposed to believe like this is your camouflage. Okay, I can be down with it somewhat, and I'm looking past it. I'm buying into the story, and I'm all about The Walking Dead. But if you take off the mask and you look like a human being and you don't have walker blood and guts on you, shouldn't they attack you? Again, it's just a fun discussion. I'm not hating or nitpicking. It's just one of those things where you're like, how is that possible? I guess we're trying to justify a fictional series, but The Walking Dead is supposed to have a realistic approach to the zombie apocalypse, if there's such a thing. Fiction and realism, does it go hand in hand? Well, sometimes, but the continuity of story has to be the same for every character, every season, every episode. Is it? Do you think it's far-fetched, or are you okay with it? Let me know your thoughts, post your comments below, and for those interested in my zombie apocalypse book series titled Fight For Us, I have 10 books available now, and the link to those books is in the description of this video and every video going forward. I hope you join the fight, and tell them, Daryl.
Yo, we love you guys. Honestly, thank you.